and Michelle Kwan still awaiting her turn on the ice. Michelle Kwan, the skater. Michelle Kwan, the person. Few intrigue us more.
There's always a constant pressure, especially when everybody's eyes are on you. You can gain strength from that pressure, or you can let it sort of eat you alive. I had a rough few months. Changing coaches. Changing choreographers.
One to the other.
I got a lot of criticism. I mean, it is hurtful to hear, like, Michelle's gone crazy. What is she doing? I was putting myself together. You know how when you finish a puzzle, you've got the last piece and it finally fits right perfectly in the middle, you know, and everything comes together.
For this practice session, I have two selections.
The Olympics, it's very different than any other competition. I've learned a lot since 98. If I had to do it all over, if I had the chance to, I would. I did a clean short, clean long. I just missed that spark. I didn't break out of the shell. I didn't go crazy. The appearance was I was cautious instead of turning it up a notch. Maybe it looked a little stale. And in 98, you come so close. And when you stand on the podium, it's like, God, there's one step higher than me. This is my second time around. And then you just don't know how many more Olympics you're gonna be in. So you just have to soak in everything. I still love Frank, and I think we were both hurt because we were ending a great 10 years. But I wanted to take responsibility of my skating and try to make decisions on my own. It is so nice having my dad down right next to the boards where all the coaches are. He's not the coach, but he's the cheerleader. I'm very comfortable with him there. I'm 21 years old now, and sometimes you have to make your own decisions. I learned the best thing to do is to listen to your own voice.
And perhaps listening to that voice at the moment.
She spent the last year trying to reignite that light from within. And this is it.
She could not have prepared for this competition any better. Every practice she's focused and she treats it like a competition.
She will be skating the same short program that she did in Nagano. And she won there.
Skaya in the lead with Cohen and Hughes second and third. So what is it like? I remember so vividly her grace accepting bitter disappointment in Nagano, but also the determination not to take the easy way out, but to come back and try to fill the only gap in her resume, which is that Olympic gold medal.
4 years is a long time to wait for 2 minutes and 40 seconds. You know, and the short program can be so cruel because everything, every deduction is mandatory. You need to skate this program as clean as possible. Just get me in the top three and I've got a chance for gold. That's all you're thinking about in the short program.
Beyond that, she's found a joy and a happiness in her skating once again. And I think that has meant more to her than anything, and even perhaps more than the results here for her personally.
And unlike Nagano, has taken full advantage of the Olympic experience here in Salt Lake City.
Well, the further away you get from your Olympic experience, the more you realize that the process is everything. Regardless of Nagano, getting to stand up there on that podium.
Marks for presentation.
3-triple lutz and a double toe. Beautiful.
Sequence.
They love her, the top U.S. skater for almost a decade. The ice showered with stuffed animals and flowers.
A personal victory, an inspired performance. There's her dad.
A thumbs up from Danny.
Nowhere near the kiss and cry.
She called him over.
She's calling him. He's awfully shy about this.
Well, you sense that she was checking off each element one at a time, but she skated with a cautious spark. She did have some fire in her eyes.
She did not have the speed that Irina had, nor the strength technically, the size of the jump. She worked that, but it was inspired.
Beautiful artistry in this program. Beautiful.
It's all about Michelle, her energy.
Skaya, the leader, is being interviewed backstage while Michelle waits on her marks.
What an incredible competition, though. We've seen so many clean performances, and we're dissecting the little details.
The quality of the skating has just been great.
Well, what Irina had was speed and power. Michelle had with grace and flow across the ice. The toe on that triple flip, though, that slipped out. That was just, that's training right there, to be able to slip off the toe and still pull off a beautiful triple flip. That's training.
Here come the marks. Required elements. 5'6" from the U.S. judge.
Those are close.
Presentation. 5'9" all the way across.
And that's her strength right there, is the beauty and the artistry of her skating from top to bottom. 5 judges to 4. Puts her in first place.
Her brother and sister applaud. After all the buildup, the short programs have lived up to what we expected.